And the point is, Anderson Cooper is just symptomatic of a bigger problem. Here, for example, is Chris Matthews on MSNB Hee Haw. He calls himself a journalist, believe it or not. And he said, quote, "My job as a journalist is to help Obama succeed," close quote, after Obama got elected. Anderson Cooper's rant was interrogation, I should say, is typical of the bias that we have every single day in this country. For example, in January 1993, the first day of Bill Clinton becoming president, here's what Peter Jennings said, because what Bill Clinton had done is reverse an anti-abortion policy that Reagan had set in. So here comes Bill Clinton's first day. Here's what Peter Jennings said. "President Clinton keeps his word on abortion rights. President Clinton kept a promise today on the 20th anniversary of the Supreme Court decision, blah, 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 blah." Now, Jennings was the anchor on the first day of George W. Bush. Now, George W. Bush reversed the pro-abortion policy that Bill Clinton had. And here's what Jennings said. Instead of saying he kept his word, kept a promise, he said, quote, "One of the president's first actions was designed to appeal to anti-abortion conservatives." Here's NBC on Bill Clinton's first day. Tom Brokaw: "Today, President Clinton kept a campaign promise," blah, blah, blah. Here is Tom Brokaw on George W. Bush's first day: "We'll begin with the new president's very active day, which started on a controversial note," referring to the abortion policy. Here's Dan Rather, first day of Bill Clinton: "On the anniversary of Roe v. Wade, President Clinton fulfills a promise," blah, 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 "delivered on his campaign promise," blah, blah, blah. On the first day of George W. Bush, Dan Rather: "This was President Bush's first day in office, and he did something to quickly please the right flank of his party." So Bill Clinton, according to Jennings and Brokaw and Rather, was fulfilling a promise, keeping a promise. And the same three felt that George W. Bush was appealing to the right flank, was starting on a controversial note. This is bias, and it is blatant.
The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
I want to get back to what we talked about a little bit yesterday when Anderson Cooper had on the Florida Attorney General, who defended a proposition that was passed by the Floridians, something like 60 to 40, overwhelmingly, amending that state's constitution to ban gay marriage and to ban civil unions. Her job as an AG is to defend laws that have been passed by the legislature or by the citizens of Florida. And now, she happens to be an opponent of same-sex marriage, but that's irrelevant. Her job was to defend a law that was dutifully and lawfully passed by the citizens of her state. And apparently, Anderson Cooper told her she was going to come on and talk about the fact that a lot of the charities that have been set up for relief for the families of those who were mowed down by the terrorists were fraudulent, and how you can make sure that when you're making a contribution, you're not ripped off. Instead, shortly after he began that line of questioning, he turned to going after her for defending this proposition, which Anderson Cooper clearly does not like, in court, and said that he had been talking to a bunch of members of the gay and lesbian community in Florida, and they did not like her, and they felt that she was hypocritical because now she was being empathetic towards gays, when in the past her opposition to same-sex marriage meant, of course, she was not empathetic to gays. Now, the idea that somebody could be an opponent of gay marriage and yet give a rip when a bunch of gays are mowed down by a terrorist seemed to have escaped Mr. Anderson Cooper when he was on the full Jorge Ramos mission. But he has responded to the criticism that I and others have addressed towards him, and here's what he said.
Now, a 360 follow about an interview I did with Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi yesterday on CNN. Now, as a rule, I think it's important that reporters not become part of the story. I don't get into feuds with other cable news anchors or professional politicians. On this broadcast, and especially in this awful tragedy, we try to keep the focus on where it should be, on the victims and the survivors and the loved ones they left behind. But today, the Attorney General went on a radio show and made some claims about our interview that are just factually incorrect. Now, she's either mistaken or she's not telling the truth. Talking about my interview with her yesterday, here's part of what she said on WOR, New York talk radio station, today.
So we've been dealing with price gouging issues, with potential scams about people trying to donate to legitimate charities, So that's what they told us they wanted us to talk about. And we felt like Anderson Cooper had a huge audience to help people yesterday. So we went over there. We went on. We were going to talk about the interview was supposed to be about helping victims' families, not creating more anger and havoc and hatred yesterday. Yesterday was about unity, about bringing people together, about helping these people. Before we went live, I said, Anderson, these are all the issues we need to help people with. He said, okay, that's great. We started off with just maybe a couple minutes, if that, about the scams, the potential scams that people all over the world want to donate, and just they need to make sure these websites are legitimate.
Now, Attorney General Bondi is correct when she says we spoke just before we went on the air live. As I do with most guests, I ask them as a courtesy what they want to talk about. So I asked her what she wanted to talk about. She mentioned possible scams that arise in the wake of tragedies, shady funeral homes she mentioned, and GoFundMe pages that her office were trying to verify as legit. Now, that's important, I said to her. Great, let's talk about it. In fact, I said, let's start with that. Let's lead off the interview with that. That's what I'll start with. She warned me she had no actual specifics about any scams, but I still said we would discuss it, and that's exactly what we did. So that's the only reason that whole topic ever came up in our discussion. But it's not true for her to say that she was booked to talk about scams in the first place. Now, you might ask, how do I know this? I know this because here are the pre-interview notes compiled by a CNN producer based on what Bondi's own office said she could possibly discuss. And nowhere in these notes were scams mentioned. In fact, right here, her office says that she could talk about the investigation process, but she couldn't get into any specifics beyond what the FBI had already said. She could say it was critical for law enforcement to be allowed to do their job properly and to avoid missteps. She also said that she could talk about the fact that she's meeting with victims' families and trying to help them, but that she also said she would not talk about gun control or any issues surrounding gun control. So that's all in the notes. So instead of following what her office suggested, I chose to ask her about comments she herself publicly has made on numerous other television show appearances.
So here he's admitting that her office and his producer or whoever it was who arranged for the interview did not at all discuss her opposition or her support for this measure that Anderson Cooper considers to be hateful towards gays, her defense of this measure, and whether or not her defending this measure is somehow contradictory towards her current expression of compassion towards the people who were mowed down. That topic was not brought up. She was blindsided by his own admission.
In just the last few days, she's been on a lot of TV, comments which seemed contradictory to her record in dealing with gays and lesbians in this state. So now another of the Attorney General's complaints.
Comments which seemed contradictory. So because you're an opponent of gay marriage, because you defended a measure that was overwhelmingly passed, by the way, by the citizens of Florida, and because you're now expressing sentiment and compassion towards the people that were killed, people who survived, and their families, that's contradictory? I mean, here he is saying this.
It's how CNN presented the interview. Listen.
When he posted the clip, he cut out the entire first portion that discussed people donating to legitimate sites.
Now, again, for the record, the interview aired live and unedited in the 2 p.m. Eastern hour yesterday on CNN. Everyone watching across the country and watching around the world saw and heard Pam Bondi say exactly what she said in real time, just as she said it. She's apparently there referring to a clip that was posted shortly after online over at CNN.com, a clip which focused just on our discussion about her public statements and her past record. Now, I don't control what's posted online. I'm here on the ground, and I'm told they routinely shorten interviews online for time. Frankly, I wish they had posted the whole thing immediately.
Bottom line here is Anderson Cooper, here he is admitting that she was not given a heads up that he intended to go after her for what he perceives to be a contradiction between her support for an anti-gay marriage measure, an anti-civil union measure that was passed by the citizens of Florida, and his obvious unhappiness with her position and the unhappiness with the position of many of the gays and lesbians Anderson Cooper spoke to. She was not given a heads up. That's just not what you do. Interviewing 101, if you're going to go after somebody, you give them a heads up. He did not do that. She deserves an apology. 888-971-SAGE. I'll play you part of that interview again to remind you of how combative it was. He acted like Jorge Ramos. First of all, you're wrong. Remember when he said that to Ann Coulter? Is that your job to tell her she's wrong about how many illegal aliens there are? I'm Larry Elder.
Larry, you are so right on about Anderson Cooper. When I listen to him berate that poor woman, it was just disgusting. I personally was opposed to gay marriage, so does that mean I'm not allowed to love and feel sorry for and feel horrible about what happened in Orlando and to treat gays kindly? So ridiculous. You are so right on, Larry.
Appreciate the call. 888-971-SAGE. So Anderson Cooper claims that he went on to say that he would be derelict in his job as a reporter if he didn't ask the Attorney General the questions that he asked her. Derelict in his job as a reporter? Now, throughout this slaughter, how many times have you seen some news angle where somebody is angry at the AG for opposing gay marriage and now is expressing sympathy towards these survivors and their families and dead people? Is that a news angle? And if it is, you didn't give her a heads up by your own admission. So here's what happened yesterday, just to refresh your recollection.
I saw you the other day saying that anyone who attacks the LGBT community, our LGBT community, you said, will be gone after with the full extent of the law.
Exactly right.
I talked to a lot of gay and lesbian people here yesterday who are not fans of yours and who said that they thought you were being a hypocrite, that you for years have fought. You've basically gone after gay people, said that in court that gay people, simply by fighting for marriage equality, were trying to do harm to the people of Florida, to induce public harm, I believe was the term you used in court. Do you really think you're a champion of the gay community?
Did she ever say she was? I mean, see how she's characterizing this? Do you really think you're a champion of the gay community? Here you are opposing same-sex marriage. Here you are defending a measure that was overwhelmingly passed by Floridians, and now you're expressing sympathy towards these victims and people who were killed because of the slaughter. Are you really a champion of the... I mean, honestly.
When I was sworn in as Attorney General, I put my hand on a Bible and was sworn to uphold the Constitution of the state of Florida. That's not a law. That was voted into our state constitution by the voters of...
And that's my job as Attorney General, to defend the laws that have been passed by the voters of Florida, irrespective of my personal opinion. Anderson.
Of Florida. That's what I was defending. Mm-hmm. Had nothing to do... I've never said I don't like gay people. That's
but
ridiculous.
You did say, but do you worry about using language accusing gay people of trying to do harm to the people of Florida when... Doesn't that
in defending the law, I've got to come up with grounds why the law is constitutional. That's what I did. That's what I had my people argue. That has nothing to do with my being here and expressing empathy towards the victims of this slaughter and the topic that you and I thought we were going to talk about, which is how people can avoid being fraudulently ripped off when they intend to donate money for the cause. That's why I thought we were here. She should have said that.
Send a message to some people who might have bad ideas
Anderson,
in mind?
Anderson, I don't believe gay people could do harm to the state of Florida.
But you argued that in court.
My lawyer argued a case defending what the Supreme Court allowed the voters to put in our state constitution.
But you were arguing that gay marriage, if there was gay marriage, if there was same-sex marriage, that would...
See, here's how it works, Anderson. When you're in court, you argue the grounds to make sure the law is lawful. Kind of like when Obama said over and over and over again that Obamacare wasn't a tax, but before the Supreme Court, his lawyers argued that it was because that was the most likely grounds upon which Obamacare would be held to be lawful. Kind of like that.
Would do harm to the people of Florida, to Florida society.
That it was constitutional to put that in the Constitution.
Are you saying you did not believe it would do harm to Florida?
Of course not. Of course not. Gay people... No, I've never said that. Those words have never come out of my mouth.
But that is specifically what you were arguing in court.
No. What we argued was it was in the Constitution of the state of Florida. Let me give you an example. Medical marijuana. A 12-year-old could get it if it passed. We took that to the Supreme Court because of that language. Hold on. But if that passed, I would defend that as well, because it's my job to defend what's in the Constitution of the state of Florida. That's what it was about.
The hotline that you've been talking about on television, which allows family members and spouses of the dead to get information,
yes,
which is incredibly important, and I appreciate you talking about it on the air. Had there been no gay marriage, had there been no same-sex marriage, you do realize that spouses, there would be no spouses, that boyfriends and girlfriends of the dead would not be able to get information and would not be able to probably even visit in the hospital here.
Well,
so isn't there a sick irony in that?
Well, yeah, and let me tell you something. Let me take it a step farther. People aren't right now, who are partners and aren't married officially, aren't able to get information. So we're trying to assist them in getting information. Because early
but
on,
isn't there a sick irony that
people,
you for years were fighting that very idea?
Is there a sick irony? I was defending the laws that were passed by the people of Florida. You don't like it. And because you don't like it, and because had the law been passed, it would have meant presumably that people could not have gotten certain information. She's the person who he puts on the rack and accuses her of being guilty of a sick irony. This is sick.
I was defending the Constitution of what's over 69% of the voters put
right
in the Constitution.
But the, you know, the courts, the federal courts.
And by the way, the same position that Hillary used to have and Obama used to have just until fairly recently. Very same position. Did he rake those two over the coals because Obama evolved on the issue?
Said that's not the Constitution,
right,
and you continued to fight it.
No, that's why we rushed it to get it to the U.S. Supreme Court,
well,
because we
before
needed
before
finality.
It was the Supreme Court, there was a federal judge, and you continued to fight it after the federal judge ruled. And, in fact, you spent hundreds of thousands of dollars of taxpayer money
well,
fighting
Anderson,
it.
We rushed to get it to the Supreme Court. You know what today's about? Human beings. Today's
right
about victims.
It's about gay and
we're
lesbian
here
victims.
It sure is.
Right.
LGBT
right
victims.
I'm just wondering,
about,
is it hypocritical to...
Still going. Still going.
To portray yourself as a champion of the gay community.
Word again, champion of the gay community. Did she ever say that? Did she ever say, I am a champion of the gay community? If so, then we got something. Possibly. Still, she would have needed a heads up. But she never said that. He said that and then beats her up for something she never said. Really unprofessional.
When I'm just reflecting what
I'm
a lot
not,
of gay people have told me, they don't see you as
Anderson,
that.
Anderson, I'm not portraying myself as anything other than trying to help human beings
right
who have lost their lives, who are right behind us right now in hospital beds, who have family members who aren't getting the services they need. This morning, you know what I've been doing? Trying to fight with a funeral home.
You know, and here is my question. How many people in the journalistic community are saying something about what Anderson Cooper said? Exactly. Same silence we heard when Jorge Ramos went after Ann Coulter. Jorge Ramos also purports to be a reporter. And said that first question when Ann Coulter was promoting her book, Adios America. First of all, you're wrong. And began to attack her for her assertion that there were 30 million illegal aliens rather than 11 million. There's a way of doing that. You don't put somebody on and tell them they're wrong and you're a reporter. Now, how many people in the journalistic community stood up there and told Jorge Ramos that he was out of line? How many people are standing up right now telling Anderson Cooper he's out of line? Exactly. They think it's perfectly okay, this is fine, for him to go into an attack mode, become an activist, become a partisan, become a prosecutor, and still calls himself a reporter with a straight face. Amazing. Chris Matthews calls himself a reporter too, remember that? It's my job as a journalist to help Obama succeed. I'm Larry Elder.